Yo, what's up, guys? It's Hopeful here. Today I'm going to be teaching you guys how to sync using Timer Map. I don't use Twixter. I think Twixter is a huge waste of time. Just because I don't, in my opinion, I think Timer Map just looks a lot cleaner and just flows a lot better. And Twixter just, it just takes too much time to sync, in my opinion, and to make it, actually look clean. You know what I mean? So, yeah, let's hop straight into it. So obviously you want to get your song of choice, and before you start syncing, you want to drop down keyframes, right? Or you want to start the shot, actually have the dude hitting the clip and then ending it, right? So to do that, all you have to do is place down keyframes. I had to rebind it. I have a 10 keyless keyboard, so my bind for adding a marker is F5. I don't know the default bind for it. I think it's the asterisk key. First, I want to show you guys the actual song I'm going to be using, just so you guys can get an idea of what So yeah, that's basically what I have so far, right? Nothing. It's obviously black. So what I'm gonna do is drop down the clip and scale it up. I render in 1440. I edit in 1440p. So yeah. And what you're going to do now is go to the keyframe where you want the actual dude to hit the shot. So boom, mine's right here. If you want to as well, you can get really technical with it, and you can go to the settings and comment on this. For instance, I could just do shot, and then it'll, leave a little marker. So what I do now is I hit the end bracket, since Max likes to record a whole 5-minute clip. Shout out to my boy Max. Thanks for the clips, dude. And then I'll drag until the first shot hits. Alt scroll to zoom in. And just kind of make it perfect. Okay, cool. So then I'll alt bracket to trim the clip up. And then I'll see where he actually starts the shot. So I'll play it. Okay, so it's pretty solid. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to do Alt-T, go over to the shot, and keyframe it. And then I'll go to the beginning and kind of just find where the actual shot starts. So he messes up the knack there. Okay, and then he gets the knack. So I'll start it right when he knacks. Okay, perfect. Now we just do the end shot. And what I like to do, if you've seen my edits and you know my style, I like to make the shot really slow. So I'll just do it like that. And now if we watch it, as you can see, it looks really choppy, but don't worry, we're going to fix that. So what I do now is, as you can see, I have these two keyframes here, just random keyframes. And that's where it's going to go fast here, slow, fast, slow, and then fast again. It's like a pump, you know what I'm saying? I don't really know how to explain it, dude. But some people, what they do is they'll drag the actual time scale and make it so that it's a lot more jumpy. I don't like that. I think it looks stupid. So I just drop down just normal keyframes, just where they're at. It still looks super clean. So once you do that, you're gonna highlight your keyframes, go to the graph editor, and on the bottom right you'll see easy ease. You click on that. And then right here in the middle, you'll see fit selection to view. I click on that as well. Then what you want to do now is alt scroll in to go side to side, zoom in side to side. And control scroll wheel is zoom up and down. So what I do now is I click on these little points right here and I drag them up and down. It's very simple. Just want to let you guys know, you don't want them to be extremely exaggerated like this, for example, because if you watch it looks like trash. So just kind of shy away from doing that. You don't want it to look like trash. You want it to look nice. So yeah, that's pretty much it. Once you get to the kill cam, you can kind of exaggerate them a little more, because the kill cam is the actual slow part of the clip. It actually looks kind of nice. So we'll go ahead and watch this. That looks really nice, but as you can see, it looks really choppy and you want it to be smooth, right? So Control Shift D to split the clip, right click on it, frame blending, click on pixel motion. This will make it look really smooth. See, I like that a lot. Also, don't worry if it's like really choppy, or not really, if it's a little bit choppy, RSMB will fix that, because you can see how it's like kind of like a little like choppy, right? RSMB will fix that, don't worry about it. It looks ugly right now, but once you add RSMB on, it's going to look sick. So now we're going to do the kill cam part. Same thing, find your keyframe you want the shot to be. End brackets to go to the end of the clip, and then bam, you hit the shot, Control-Alt-T. I don't mess around with any of the keyframes. I just drop down straight timer map keyframes. That's it. I just click on this throughout the whole shot. Some people mess around and they'll make the kill cam. They'll like mess with this to like, you know, make it start where they want to. I don't think it looks good. I think it flows perfect when you just have it like straight up. You know what I'm saying? Just a normal. So once again, you highlight these, easy ease them, click on the fit selection to view, and now we're on the kill cam part. So like I said, you can kind of exaggerate these a little more since it's the kill cam and the kill cam's already slow as it is. So yeah, just exaggerate them a little bit more, not too much. You don't want it to be like extremely pumpy, you know what I mean? You want it to like kind of vibe with the song. Yeah, in my opinion, that looks really nice. Let's watch that again. Maybe even like tone it down a little bit. You know what I mean? Tone down the graphs just a little bit. In my opinion, I think it's a little too jumpy. So I'm just gonna play with them. That's ultimately what you have to do. Is you just have to play around with your graph, right? So let's go ahead and do that. Tone it down a little bit. Yeah, that looks a lot nicer. As you can see, when it was exaggerated, like the actual keyframes were exaggerated, it looked a little too jumpy and it just didn't flow with the song. But as you can see now, the clip starts randomly, like it just shows up randomly. And that just throws off the entire edit. So what I do from here is I click T to bring up the opacity, turn it all the way down, keyframe it, go to where you want the shot to start, go to 100, highlight them, easy ease them again. And then what I do here is I just literally drag the bottom one all the way up. That's it. You can drag this one a little bit too, like out as well. Because as you can see, if you drag it down, it like fades in like too fast. And you don't want that. See, it just like what is that? Looks really bad. You want it to ease in nice. You know what I mean? So we'll go ahead and watch it now. Watch the whole shot. Yeah, that's pretty much it. That's how I sync. That's how I do, you know, my syncing. If you guys enjoyed, want any more tutorials, I think I'm going to do a motion track tutorial coming up soon. But if there's anything else you guys need help with, don't hesitate to leave a comment. Let me know. I'm down to do these tutorials. But yeah, it's been hopeful. Hope you guys enjoy. I'm out. Peace out, dude.